This is fun stuff because you literally have the opportunity in your life to sit in the air-conditioned environment and just dial numbers with your finger, literally go like this, and call people to see how they're doing and see if there's anything you can do to help them, you know, in terms of using your services as a real estate agent that they need, by the way. You know, you have to, every single person goes through these stages, okay? So when you're scared in the beginning, that's totally normal. Every single person goes through that. So you just gotta go through the stages as quickly as you can. That's what winners do, okay? So you have to look at yourself in the mirror every day and say, am I a winner? Okay, because if I'm not, I'm gonna make excuses and let my fears and insecurities hold me back from doing the things I know I need to do. Right? And listen, there's no way that I'm going to be able to stop you from being a loser if you're a loser. You're going to make excuses to be a loser. You're going to say, this year was tough. Inventory was really low. And next year, the losers, the same agents, are going to say, year was really tough. Too much inventory. No matter what the market gives you, they're going to make it an excuse of why they're not producing. Right, and then they're gonna say they're scared, or they're gonna say, well, I don't wanna call people because they might be at work, or maybe, you know, they assume that the person doesn't wanna work with them, or whatever. It's all loser talk. Just have fun. Listen, you're looking at it like it's a chore, like it's some kind of really negative, horrible thing to do, a task, when really you should be looking at it like this is fun stuff because you literally have the opportunity in your life to sit in the air-conditioned environment and just dial numbers with your finger, literally go like this, and call people to see how they're doing and see if there's anything you can do to help them, you know, in terms of using your services as a real estate agent that they need, by the way. And there's people out there digging ditches and roofing houses and plumbing houses and, you know, doing 9-to-5s and, you know, cooking at restaurants and serving tables and doing all kinds of things that I'm sure you would, maybe you would rather do those things than make calls and sitting at an office and, you know, checking on people to see how they're doing. Maybe you would rather go flip burgers or something like that. Maybe it's so bad to call people and check on them, see how they're doing. You would rather go do some of these hard labor activities. But I would rather focus on helping people and sitting in an air-conditioned environment where I control my schedule. I can go spend time with my family. You guys don't understand. For you to sit here and complain about, I'm just not trying to be mean here, but I'm just saying, for you to sit here and complain or say, you know, about phone calls and stuff, it blows my mind how you're not looking at it as the most incredible opportunity ever in the face of the planet in the history of the world. It's insane to me. So, like I said, I can't stop a loser from losing and making these excuses. And on the flip side, I can't prevent or say anything that's going to stop a winner from winning. The winners are going to go out there no matter what I say, and they're going to find a way to make it happen. So what side of that coin are you on? Okay, because at the end of the day, regardless of where you get your leads from, okay, when you get a Zillow lead for $200, what's the first thing you have to do?
Gotta call them.
Okay, so now we're trying to pay money, okay, we're paying money to avoid making calls just to turn right around and call them. Okay? It's absurd the you know, hundreds of thousands of agents out there trying to avoid making calls by spending thousands of dollars on leads just to turn right around and call them. It's nuts, right? If you get Facebook leads, if you do open houses, if you're doing sphere of influence, if you're sending postcards, whatever you're doing results to the same exact action, right? That funnel, no matter what your lead generation source is, the funnel comes right back to the same activity, one-on-one conversation. So what you gotta realize is that if you wanna build $1 million a year real estate business, the only thing between you and that $1 million a year are thousands of one-on-one conversations with people in your market. How you have those conversations, I could care less. As long as you're having them and you have a plan where, you know, I'm gonna have 5 great conversations a day or 10 great conversations a day or whatever the case may be, that you know over the course of 3 to 5 years, you've had those thousands of one-on-one conversations with people in your market, that's going to allow you to accumulate all those relationships and build your brand up to the point where you can make that $1 million. I don't care what your lead generation source of choice is, as long as it's producing the adequate amount of one-on-one conversations that need to be had over the next 3 to 5 to 10 years to build your business to the point that you want. I'm not going to argue the what lead generation source is the best, because I don't know what's best for you. Maybe it is spending $100 per lead on Zillow. I don't know. But at the end of the day, I know that I've got to get out there and produce one-on-one conversations with people in my market, or I'm not growing a business, right? You should have a system in place where anybody you ever talk to never forgets who you are, regardless of the outcome of that immediate relationship, whether they buy or sell something right then, whether they said they would and ghosted you, whether they looked at properties and said, we're not interested right now. Whatever the case may be, there's got to be a system in place where you gather all the data of everybody you ever meet or talk to. You've got to have a system in place that never allows them to ever forget who you are from that point forward. Now, if they unsubscribe or block or whatever from that system, then you can't do anything about that. Okay, allow them to do that if that's what they wish to do, and that's going to happen, and who cares, right? We want to filter the population down to the people who love us. There's an unlimited amount of people in your market who will love you, right? As soon as they have that one-on-one conversation and get to know you, and then see and feel that personal branding on the backside of that great first impression. Problem is, You're not willing to put the work in to have all the one-on-one conversations that need to be had, right? To build that up, and you're doing yourself, your customers, the community, your market, your coworkers, your family, everyone a disservice, right? Every time you decide not to spend time, trying to reach out to people in the community, you need to think of yourself as a volunteer worker. Okay, and you're doing community outreach to see what you can do to help people in your community. There are closings happening every day and will forever for the rest of your life. And those are in MLS, people represented by a real estate agent, by the truckloads. And so these are people that need your help. You got to get out there and realize that this is fun and that people need your help. And that you've got to get out there and push as hard as you can. All of you on this call are, in my opinion, great agents, right? You're honest, dependable, hardworking, consistent. You know, you do everything you say you're going to do. You want the best for people, right? That's the definition of great agent. But there's a big difference in actually having the qualities of a great agent and being a great agent. Like, I could probably trust any of you to do a transaction for me, and you'd probably do an amazing job in the transaction. Right? You're a great agent. But a lot of you might be great agents who aren't selling a lot of real estate. There's a difference in great agent that can handle the transaction the way that people, want and give them a great experience. There's a big difference in people who are just great agents and great agents who actually sell a lot of real estate. And that's what I want, right? I want to take you from great agent who can handle the transaction and give me a great experience to a great agent who sells a lot of real estate. Big difference there. So all of you are great agents. That's easy. Be a good person. Work hard. Be dependable. Honest. All that stuff. Cool. Let's put some systems in place where now we can scale that greatness to the place where more people know about our greatness and want to use our services to help them have great experiences in their transactions, right? Buyers are everywhere, I mean, marketing is easy. All these companies have made the world so small. And, that's not where we're needed on the marketing end. We don't need to be, pushing the fact that, we're going to do this marketing and that marketing. We're going to put it out here and there and everywhere. And they don't really care about that because they can do all that on their own. Okay, they don't need us for that part. What they need us for is pricing it to make sure we're not leaving money on the table. What they need us for is negotiating and being that third party that has their best interest to make sure it's somebody that's a skilled professional negotiator. You know, like, I know how to squeeze people. I know when people are just trying to play us for more money. I know when we, I know how to maneuver through negotiations to squeeze the best out for my client. If you've only sold, you know, two properties as a non-real estate agent, you've sold two of your own properties in your life. The last one was 5 years ago. I mean, this is a whole new world. You need a professional to help you squeeze the most money out of this property, number one. Number two, helping them through the process of the transaction. You know, they don't really want to, number one, they don't know all these things. They don't want to even learn or deal with, you know, all the intricate parts of the transaction that we all take for granted. You know, like, we do, you know, the financing and the inspection and the appraisal and the title company and all the different parts of the transaction. We do this every day, so this is like nothing to us. But for somebody who doesn't do this, this is treacherous. This looks scary. You know, so they need us to help them make sure they're not leaving money on the table, that there's not something in the contract that might be against their best interest. Okay, there's a lot of things there that could get slid into the contract, and to help them through the transaction and make it a smooth transaction from their point of view. You know, our job is to take all that pressure of the transaction off their shoulders and take that pressure on for them, and sometimes not even inform them of some of the stuff going on the back end, just so they're not worried about stuff. We want them to be as least worried as possible.